Welcome to the presentation for the SIGIR resource paper on the information retrieval experiment platform called T-Rex, which is joint work by Mike Fröbel, Jan-Heinrich Reimer, Sean McAveney, Niklas Deggers, Simon Reich, Yannick Bewendorf, Benno Stein, Matthias Hagen and Martin Potthast. The motivation of this experiment platform T-Rex is that if we do experiments and research in information retrieval, we want that they are very robust in the sense of that the results and the knowledge that we extract from our experiments are correct. And often our research in IR is driven by shared tasks. So we of course also want that our shared tasks are robust in the sense that the knowledge and the results that we chain from shared tasks are very robust. Here we see an example of a shared task that is not robust because here is a very fragile component, and if this component fails or is not true, then everything crashes together. So this shared task would be not robust, and there are of course many ideas in the research community what those component that causes that everything crashes together might be. For example, Norbert Fuhr mentioned mainly two problems in his SIGIR 2021 keynote, namely problem one with internal validity and problem two with external validity that can be problems in information retrieval research. And nowadays there might be a third problem that we can't really do blinded experimentation with large language models that have seen all the training data or many of the training data available on the web. So let me give you some more details on those three problems and how T-Rex can address them. So the problem one on internal validity. The goal of internal validity is that we say something is internally valid if the hypothesis is supported by the data. Some possible problems that would violate the internal validity are, for example, if we choose a wrong baseline for our experimentation, or for example if we formulate an hypothesis after we have done the tests and the experiments and have looked into the data. There are of course also some possible solutions like centralized leaderboards or task-specific leaderboards, but they have not gained enough traction so that they at the moment at least can solve this problem of internal validity. The second problem of external validity addresses basically reproducibility. So we say that something is externally valid if repeating an experiment on similar data yields similar observations. And the main problem that would, for example, violate external validity is if we have results that are not reproducible. So in the sense of we repeat an experiment on slightly different data, but we get different observations. And again, there are of course many possible solutions to address the problem of external validity, for example, track open runs or many reproducibility initiatives like OSIRRC or Centre. Of course, there are also already platforms and documentation approaches to address this challenge, and also meta-evaluations like BIR explicitly tackle or work on tackling this problem of external validity. But there are of course again some problems. I don't want to go into all of the details, but basically all possible solutions have some shortcomings, of course, because there is no silver bullet. And the third problem that is now very pressing to our community is that we cannot really evaluate large language models. So we cannot do blinded experimentation with large language models at the moment. Here we have a statement by Percy Liang, and he says that he worries about large language models being trained on test sets, because this would in the end invalidate the conclusions that we do. And Percy wrote an email to support at OpenAI to opt out of having the test data used to improve the models. but he also mentions a very interesting and important point that this is not enough because offers that run evals could still inadvertently contribute those test sets to training because the models, the large language models are often trained now with human feedback. So even if they opt out from having the their test data as part of improving the model, it can be still be the case that this is inadvertently be done. Here in a second example that someone recently shared on Twitter, where Horace expected that the GPT-4 performance is influenced by data contamination for code force, and the example here is that GPT-4 solves 10 out of 10 coding problems that were released before 2021, and 0 of 10 of coding problems released after 2021. So this really, really highlights the problems that we might get with evaluation of large language models. And we now propose the information retrieval platform T-Rex to address basically all of those three problems. And what T-Rex does is only one thing. It integrates three existing tools into each other. It integrates Tira, which is a research software for reproducible shared tasks. And Tira works by making software submissions and blinded experiments. And because of allowing software submissions and blinded experiments, this is already a way to mitigate the three problems that we saw earlier. T-Rex also integrates IR datasets to allow unified and random access to documents, queries, and relevance judgments, and PyTerrier for declarative reproducibility pipelines to increase the benefits that we get out of shared tasks after a shared task is done. The basic idea of T-Rex is that organizers provide a private Docker image with a potentially private Docker image with an IR datasets integration, and participants provide Docker images with retrieval approaches, and then the Docker images of participants are executed on the potentially private data that is never can never be leaked in a sandbox. And this T-Rex with this covers shared tasks end to end in the sense of the corpus and topics go into IR datasets, this goes into T-Rex, participants develop their approach and make software submissions in case the organizers allow to release the data. Participants can also make run submissions, and all of this is gathered in Tira, which ensures that it is reproducible and replicable by software submissions. And after a shared task is then finished, the shared tasks artifacts are publicly released so that other researchers can reuse the approaches because they are already in the Docker image and also the data produced. We did a feasibility study to show that T-Rex scales, and for that we dockerized 50 retrieval models to Tira that are derived from 4 starters that cover basically basically major retrieval frameworks. They retrieve against the default text in IR datasets, and this already helps because we here in T-Rex we now have 50 transferable retrieval baselines. This already allows to improve selecting a suitable baseline because the leaderboards are public, and this helps to improve internal validity because it is transparent what are good baselines and what are not good baselines for a shared task. We did run all of the 50 retrieval models on 32 retrieval benchmarks in Tira. So this means the retrieval models can be transferred to new corpora. They can explicitly run and execute on new corpora, which improves the external validity. And here we have an overview of the 32 benchmarks. They cover a very wide range of classic standard track style benchmarks, from very small corpora, for example Cranfield with roughly 1000 documents, to very large corpora like the CLUVIP 09 with 1 billion documents, and a wide diverse range in between. we did run all the 50 retrieval models on all the 32 benchmarks, which yielded 1600 runs. This took roughly 1 week. All of the baselines and leaderboards are publicly available, which might help for additional use cases like learning to rank or query performance prediction. And as a very small teaser on the results, we did a reproducibility study with repo eval, and we observed, for example, system preferences on Track Deep Learning 2019, and used repo eval to measure what proportion of system preferences are reproducible to offer shared tasks. And for example, in comparison to Track Deep Learning 2020, 85% of the system preferences are reproducible, and then it goes down to 28% for Grainfield, for example, and everything in between. For example, already on rank 15, there's only a success rate of a reproducibility success rate of 53%. To sum things up, T-Rex is basically an integration of existing tools, TIRA for reproducible shared task, IR datasets for easy data access, and PyTerrier for reproducibility notebooks. And we hope that T-Rex helps to improve the benefit-effort ratio for shared tasks in comparison to previous approaches, because it is possible to make one software submission and evaluate it on many datasets. And one can also run evaluations on datasets to which one does not have access, as in the case for blinded experimentation with large language models. As future work, we would like to also support generative IR, for example by integrating models like Alpaca via a service, and we also want to scale the infrastructure behind this TIRA framework to the cloud of the Open Search Foundation. We also want to render search engine result pages with DiffIR, and of course we would be very happy if you consider to use T-Rex in your shared task, and we would be very happy to help you with that. That's it. Thank you for your attention.